How you doing? I'm Gregory in North Carolina. Whether you voted for Donald Trump or not, whether you like Donald Trump or not, whether you agree with Donald Trump or not, the flat cold reality is that he can't govern. He cannot lead and he cannot govern. Now, I'm a registered Republican, have been my entire life, cast my first vote for Ronald Reagan. I am a second generation Eagle Scout, a husband, a father, an entrepreneur, a homeowner, and an acolyte in my church. And what I've seen from all of those perspectives is just mortifying. We have more than 100,000 dead from a pandemic, and we have more than 40 million unemployed, both the worst crises in living memory. And those happened on his watch. They are his responsibility. His utter inability to lead or govern has made them both much worse. Everyone has been disappointed. People who hoped he was fresh and different have seen that he's just another demagogue. People who hoped that he would drain the swamp, as he said, have just watched him pander to his cronies. People who hoped he would shake things up have seen him tear things down. People who hoped he was the broken vessel that would bring closer God's kingdom have seen and realized that he is just another false prophet. People who thought he was a savvy businessman with the art of the deal have seen that he's just another carnival barker. Remember, Ronald Reagan was always smiling and cheerful. Trump was always scowling and ranting. Lincoln spoke eloquently of malice towards none and charity for all. Trump tweets incoherent rage. Theodore Roosevelt personally led the charge up San Juan Hill in the Spanish-American War. And Dwight Eisenhower was the Allied commander on D-Day. Trump tried to turn the army on unarmed citizens while he hid in a bunker. No matter what anyone thought in 2016, what we've seen in the past 3 years, 3.5 years, is that Trump is as clueless and inept as Herbert Hoover and as paranoid and vindictive as Richard Nixon. His meanness and his pettiness demean the country and they demean his office. It's long past time for everyone to admit that this strutting, arrogant wannabe emperor has no clothes. Whatever anyone hoped is just simply not there. Trump and his bootlickers have done far too much damage already, and it's time for him to go.